So few people are new. How many people are first time listening to me? Not few. Majority. So in these 3 hours we'll be discussing about rubrics. Understanding the rubrics and their practical application in the clinic. Is it audible? Hello. So I'll be speaking in English, which is really difficult for me because it is not my first language. Because you know, in Hindi you can feel it and express, but in English you have to express and feel it. But still, for better, you know, what you can tell for better approach to other people on the net or something like that, the organization thinking. So I am honored that they have given me a chance to speak in this auditorium for 3 hours about rubrics. So basically, if you go back, what is a rubric? You want me to speak or you want to interact? Both. So what is a rubric? When you don't talk for 3 seconds, I'll start talking. So rubric is basically one word or few words, and this is taken from Materia Medica. The words are basically the expression or the feeling of the provers put in the Materia Medica and indexed in the repertory. So why it is done like this? Because it is not easy to find out the individual, right individual, from the Materia Medica. It is very vast. Each remedy has thousands of expressions and feelings, and we have to zoom down to the simillimum. So for that we need rubrics. Because it is indexed alphabetically, so one by one we can find it. But mind you, it is not at all mathematical. Very, you know, many people think that you take rubric, a patient comes and speaks something, you take one rubric, speaks another thing, take another rubric, take 3 or 4 rubrics, repertorize it, and give the remedy which is containing the maximum marks or maximum grade. This is not homeopathy. Because you have to feel that rubric. See, let us start with the first rubric in our repertory. First rubric. You can take any repertory. We have complete. We have few repertories, you know, complete, synthesis, the original. Actually, the first rubric in Kent repertory is, if you go to the first rubric, it is abandoned. And the rubric is abandoned. You see? Actually, this is the beauty of advancement of repertory. The original, the first rubric is abandoned, and there is no rubric like abandoned. I don't know why this is this a printing mistake or something. It is not a printing mistake. Actually, we are not understanding the rubric, and we have written C for second. So we have to go back to for second to understand abandoned. So why the need of 2 words then? So this is mechanical thing what we are doing in the recent repertories, which has to be avoided. So how do you differentiate these 2 words? One is abandon, another is forsaken. If you tell by 3-4 seconds, I'll listen to you or I'll explain. Anybody can tell what is the meaning of abandon, and what is the meaning? How do we differentiate it from forsaken? Or both are same? Very good. Very good. See, you have the one aircraft from Malaysian Airlines. It last month or so, actually it crashed on the sea, and they tried to search so many months, so many days, and now the search was abandoned. The search was not forsaken. Hello, please try to understand this. So totally, you feel now it is useless to pursue it. Is it clear? Hello. So somebody abandons you because you are useless. You are not at all useful to me now. So I'll abandon you. But forsaken is my feeling, and it is emotional, more of emotional. than totally, you know, just feeling that other person is useless. But per second, I feel that this person is not at all in touch with me, not in affection with me, not at all liking me, not at all giving importance to me. This is per second. Is it clear? Exactly. It is bit of emotional things. In abandon, see, you have, when you are going through a train, by a train, you can see there are buildings where it is written abandoned. The old water tanks, the old stations. So it is of no use now. So here the feeling is different. Is it clear? Here I feel that I am being forced again. And in abandon, other person abandons it because you are useless. So why I have given you the example of this rubric? So how you are basically in the advancement of the repertories, we basically turn the repertory into mathematical conditions, which is not at all agreeable. We have to feel the rubrics. So in these 3 hours, I'll try to take you into the understanding of the rubric, and especially which are found in, see, there are thousands of rubric in our repertory. It's not easy to make every rubric understand, but I'll try to focus on those rubrics which are found in our clinic day by day, every patient you find it. So we'll go one by one. Yeah. Same thing, na? In 4 seconds, you're not saying, you're feeling it. In 4 seconds, you can feel that. See, sir, since last few months, my husband is not at all looking at me. He's not paying, you know, any heed to me. He's not at all taking interest in me. Is it clear? Hello, you're getting. In abandoned, the other person, yeah, you are not no more required. I feel just he has deserted me like anything. Is it clear? So in 4 seconds, there is emotional attachment between the two persons. See, every chronic problem, every chronic disease, it happens because of there is a relationship problem. In other, some we are telling at interpersonal relation. Actually, it is not interpersonal. It is actually basically our feeling how we take the relationship. Every remedy, if I get time, I'll tell how the remedies feel sick because of the relationship. Just one example. See, what is the relationship? What is a relationship for sepia? Yes? What is relationship? Yes? What is relationship for sepia? No, burden? Yes? No indifference? Yes, yes. Further, duty, you know, there are so many rubrics coming on the duty, responsibility. Then you will be, you have to differentiate like abandon and forsaken, duty and responsibility. Because right use of rubric is mandatory. You have to. You cannot use duty in responsibility and responsibility in duty. CPI is relationship of reciprocation. Relationship of reciprocation. What is reciprocation? I cannot speak in Hindi. See, in reciprocation, see, I expect you to do for me. I expect you to do for me. At the same time, I enjoyed doing for you. This is actually basically CPS feeling. I expect you to do for me. If you don't do, then I'll start hating you, being indifferent to you, being violent to you, all these things. But till that time, I'll enjoy doing for you. This is reciprocationship, relationship of reciprocation. Every remedy, like Ignatia. Ignatia is what is? Relationship of morality. So, morality. What people will say and what I feel. Morality and conscience. Ignatia is not guided by reciprocation. And Cocculus is relationship of care. How much I can give you, whether you give me or not. How much I can give you. So likewise, we have to understand so many, there are all the medicines, you know, they have some relationship problem. And when they go into that problem, they fall sick.